Finally got my nunchuck back from Jenna.
She just put it out on her porch and I went to get it. And also you may have heard Beach Ball Galaxy. Me and Billy just recorded the second to last and the last episode of Galaxy Versus. And the footage for the second to last one decided it didn't want to export correctly from the Elgato software, so I'm screen recording it using the Elgato. And I figured out how to get this monitor to work with it. Audio's off sync, but I can hopefully fix that, and I'm just gonna leave it to screen record. It was like a 40-minute episode, and it's been recording for 22. I just recorded Sonic Heroes for 1 hour and 30 seconds, and it's still processing, and I've finished like 6 minutes ago. I'm actually just replaying through the levels that I failed to get an A rank on, and yeah, I just got an A rank, no problem. It was the first two levels that I didn't get A ranks on. I recorded the first Seaside Hill and Ocean Palace and the boss, Grand Metropolis and Power Plant and the boss, and then also Casino Park and Bingo Highway and the boss of that. And I've gotten all the Chaos Emeralds so far, so that's good. I'm just gonna go ahead and A rank Ocean Palace.
That's still exporting. It's been going a good half an hour. I don't know why it's taking so long, but I actually just started packing a little bit. If I show you. Close the door. I've borrowed 3 Wii remotes from Dad, because one of mine's got a broken motion sensor. So I'll be taking one of mine, and my 2 nunchucks, 3 of Dad's Wiimotes and 2 of his nunchucks, and they're all in little plastic bags in here. And I've also got 4 GameCube controllers in there, and my Pro controller. And that's all in that front pocket. Somehow I managed to fit it all in that front bit. Up here, I think I've got my 3DS in there, yeah, my charging cable for it, the game card case with a bunch of 3DS and DS games in it, and I'm also going to have my little disc folder, tiny little holder thing to take some disc-based games in. And then in here, that's just some GoPro stuff in case I need it, also in a plastic bag. I'm going to fit my laptop, my Wii U, my Wii, and the gamepad all in here, and my microphone, the mic stand. I'm gonna have to put in a suitcase, so I can get it in. I've gotta still record 3 DuckTales videos before we set off tomorrow, and before we pack it, and I believe if we're packing this in the suitcase, Mum's gonna want it today. So I need to get on with recording DuckTales, but I can't until Sonic Heroes is exported, which is taking forever for whatever reason, so. Yeah, and I can't think of anything else I need to get in here, other than fave. Oh, I've also somehow gotten the GameCube adapter in that front pocket as well. It's a good suitcase. So it turns out it recorded in 30 frames per second for some reason. So now I've got to redo the Sonic Heroes recording. Good. I'm not 100% sure why it recorded in 29 frames per second as opposed to 60. Because it's displaying in 60 now in the Elgato software, and it definitely runs at 60. Well, oh, hold on. It looks like it recorded it at some weird frame width. Hold on, I'm going to check if this was just an export thing. Watching it in the Elgato software, it's definitely at 60 FPS. I think it just exported in some weird thing. That might explain why it took so long to export. It took like half an hour. I'm gonna try some other exporting stuff. So it's saying it's gonna take forever to export again, like it did last time. So I think I'm just gonna record the rest of DuckTales that I need to record and then try and get that exported and re-record if I need to. So this is the raw recording stuff, 59 frames per second. I checked one of the exports that I ended up canceling and it had exported in 30. I don't know why, it's been recorded in 59, it just refuses to export in that. Alright, I think I worked out a solution. I've actually gone and had dinner before this. I left it to convert in FreeMake to see if that had sorted it. It didn't. If I put it in Vegas, everything is on sync in this recording, like the raw stuff. Normally it's off sync, audio and stuff, but it's all on sync because it didn't technically corrupt. So what I'm going to do, when I put the 2 raw video files into editing software, they don't have audio, but when I put the one that rendered out in 30 frames,
That one still has the audio, so I'll take the audio from that one and the video from the two that are in the right resolution and the right frame rate. Put them together, boom, got a project. Now to record DuckTales. I don't know why I didn't think of that to start with. Okay, I recorded the three DuckTales videos that I needed. Took an hour and a half, but it's done. Oh, now I've got to wait for it to export. I just hope it doesn't have the same glitch that the Sonic Heroes video did, and that it is in fact in 60 frames per second. I don't know why it did that, because that would mean that I'd have to use the raw stuff from that as well, but I don't know. I mean, I recorded Galaxy Versus earlier, and from what I can tell, actually, you know what? I haven't actually checked that footage. I'm going to check that footage right now and see if it is actually in 60 frames. I mean, one of them, like I said earlier, I had to screen record it, but I didn't actually check the other one, episode 20, which is actually the finale. Like I said, we finished recording it. The finale was recorded, and it's weird to think that Galaxy Versus is essentially over. I don't know, it's going really slow because it's exporting from the Elgato, so I'll check that in a moment.
Yep, that one's in, well, 59, but...
Okay, I don't know what happened to Sonic Heroes then. Alright, and Versus is rendering. That's due out tomorrow at 1 p.m. and we're setting off for the airport at 1 p.m. Possibly a little bit before that. It's currently 10 p.m. And this usually takes about 12 hours to render. So it should be done by 10 a.m. Get it uploaded, get it scheduled, get a couple more videos up that I already have rendered, get those scheduled, and I'm set for at least 3 or 4 days, I think. So, yeah. I'm in the process of packing. I can't finish packing until this is finished rendering so I can put my laptop in. But, I actually didn't. It turns out when I'm editing Galaxy Versus, normally all the raw footage is on my external hard drive. And I render to another external hard drive. Galaxy Versus, I keep everything on the actual laptop, just because it speeds, like, if it's off of an external hard drive, the renders go a little bit quicker. So I can pack my external hard drives. I don't need to worry about that, because I've just got them all unplugged. All I have is the mouse and, like, the power cable, second monitor, which I'm going to unplug now, and the cooling mat. But, anyway, that is going to do it for today's vlog. I'm still not revealing where we're going until tomorrow. So, yeah. Anyway, we're going until the 6th. I think I've mentioned that. Thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then. One last thing, actually. I was just repacking, and basically what I decided is a better idea because of what I'm going to have to get out of this case at security. I've put the Wii U and the gamepad in this pocket. It kind of moved over, but, and then the Wii actually managed to fit in this pocket, and then, because I'm going to have to get those out to put them through separately as security, and then inside, I've got everything else, so putting them in these bags definitely helped, I feel. I don't know, they don't make as much noise for one thing. I've just got all my controllers in here, and like power bricks and things like that. Games here. It's a thingy full of games. That's a mic stand because we can't actually take that one. It's going to make the case too heavy, so I'm going to have to deal without that. But I'm sure we'll find a table or something to put the little old mic stand on that I've got. And then I've got the microphone is in here. I'll probably put that either there or on the top. And then laid across all of this, I'm going to have my laptop. Because that's going to be like the last thing to go in, as well as the power cable for that. I'm not going to take the cooling mat because I won't be able to get it in there. So there's just a couple last minute things, and then I'm going to take this as well because you're allowed one small bag, alongside like a big carry-on bag. So I'm taking this little drawstring bag. I've actually got my backpack in the suitcase. Admittedly, I could take that one. Probably should, but I'm just going to take this, and it's got my 3DS, it's going to have my camera in it, my phone and things like that, just to have like stuff I want readily available on the flight, and then this can just go in the overhead bin, so, yeah. Also, you know what I just realized? There's a little thing, a zip at the bottom of this, which basically goes into the back of the case. You're not really supposed to put stuff in there, but I put a few cables in there, and one of them is a hard drive cable. Three of them are hard drive cables. I need one of those. I'm gonna have to dig through this.